I'm giving you a little synopsis like I have in the past, a little two-page letter, and then there's three pages of financial information behind it. These are the draft financials. We should have the finals completed within the next week or two. So don't anticipate any numbers changing at all from this point in time. The numbers will be the same. It'll be just wrapping up our information. If you want to flip over to page three, the way I've got this thing set up is page three is the general fund. Page four is the special revenue and capital projects. And page five is the enterprise funds and internal service funds. So page three is the general fund, and the general fund is obviously your biggest fund you have. It has all the workings of the county in this department. So for 2017, these are June 30th, 2017 numbers. Total revenue for the general fund was $54,387,000. Compared to the budget was $54,288. And you compare that with the 2016 actual numbers, $50,140. So increase of about $4,300,000 over the previous year, right in line with the budget. And you can see that most of the increase is in taxes this year, and it's in property taxes. Sales taxes pretty much straight across, you know, no real increase on that, but the majority of that is in the property taxes for this year. Accounted total taxes, $47,986,000. Dropping down to the expenditures, total general government, $19,927,000. Just under budget of $20,405,000. And a little bit higher, about $2,500,000 above the 2016 number of $17,484,000. Public safety accounts for almost 38% of your budget. Public safety was $20,639,000, right in line with the budget. And up about $1,200,000 from the previous year, $19,474,000. Public works, $5,017,000 compares to the budget, up just about $200,000 from 2016 numbers. Health and welfare, $770,000 compared to the budget, up about $50,000 over 2016. The culture and recreation, the library is, those are the appropriations for the library. They're pretty well in line with the budget. The parks and rec and the industrial authority are basically pass-throughs. You take that, those taxes that you receive for them, and you just pass them back through, and they show up. So total expenditures for 2017 were $54,468,000 compared to the budget of $55,021,000 and compared to 2016 actual of $50,076,000. Your change in fund balance this year, $653,000 compared to $250,000 last year. And your fund balance at the end of the year was
$15,924,000.
Clay, I need to repeat that. Mark, while you're there, have you, through any of the other communities that y'all have volunteered or worked with, seen the same similarities in the reduction in SPOS numbers?
Yeah, we're seeing it across the board from what we see. Now, you know, we're seeing, you know, the South Georgia area.
Yeah.
So, but, yeah, we, you know, we have some clients over around Savannah, and they're seeing the same thing.
So it's just, it's not just an anomaly for us.
No.
That is something that is unique to Lowndes County. It just seems to be. Is it fair to say it's something more, it's more occurring more in the southern part of the state than it is, you think, in some of the other regions?
I think it's happening across the state. some of the classes we go to, they're always talking about it. And, you know, there's a lot of northern counties and even into Atlanta that talk about they're not seeing the jump.
The reason I'm asking is because some of the information we get from the state level is indicative of they are experiencing increases.
Oh, really?
So,
well, that started in July after this fiscal year, and I'll have a graph for you later. Lowndes County's taken off, and so has Ware County. So, for some reason, there's been an increase. I could not get an updated commodities report on the Department of Revenue, so I can't even tell you where it's coming from. But it's significant, it's steady, and it's strong.
But that's an increase from July.
July up right through December, it's been a steady increase every month.
Which is nice.
I'm sorry, go ahead.
Yeah. Any other questions on the general fund?
These increases, are these figures like Parks and Rec and Industrial Authority, that amount, is that a mill?
The Parks and Rec is a 1.25, and the Industrial Authority is 1.
Yeah, correct. Okay. 1? Okay. I thought so. Thank you.
Yeah, that's why they're a little different numbers. Just a little bit.
I just want to make sure in my mind.
Yeah.
Morning, every morning, based off the property value.
That's right. Any questions? All right. Okay, let's flip over to the next page, to page 4, and this is the special revenues and the capital projects. So, taking an overview of the special revenue, total for 2017 was $11,322,000 for revenues. Expenditures were $11,550,000. So we have the 2016 numbers right beside $10,211,000 for 16 and $9,795,000 for the expenses. So not a lot of change overall in between the two years. Drilling down a little bit, the special services accounted for $4,265,000 of the revenues and $3,271,000 of the expenditures. And those were pretty well in line with the previous year. Intergovernmental grants, $2,216,000 for the year and $2,210,000 of expenses. The E911 revenues were $2,413,000 and expenses were $3,269,000. Any questions on the special revenues?
The revenue from the E911 comes from the assessment on the phone line, and I think that there has been some discussion in regards to try to increase that. Is that at the legislature? They have that.
Some legislation that's been proposed about the creation of a commission or authority or committee on more supervision of the 911 operations and also an increase in those funds. Again, it is funds that go to the state initially and then come back to the counties.
Which right now, it's just coming right from your providers and you're relying on them to be accurate. I have a hesitation about going to the state and coming back to the
sometimes you send a dollar and you get back about 45 cents.
Yeah.
I don't know how that works.
Must be a handling fee up there.
What is included, and I've asked this before, excuse me for my Teflon memory, what's included in special services? I get all this other stuff. Special services is what?
All those across the top.
Everything.
It's all the unincorporated services only. Planning, zoning, fire.
Anything.
So anything that's just for the unincorporated area.
Okay.
Yeah, like the local license.
Okay, we'll go on to the capital projects. This year, the total capital projects accounted for revenues of $21,750,000 compared to $21,538,000 last year. Total expenditures were $17,637,000 compared to $20,937,000 last year. So the majority of the activity in here is the SPLOS activity. And the revenues normally stay the same every year. They're pretty close to the same. Your expenditures will cycle based on what projects you have going on at that point in time. So sometimes that number will be higher, sometimes it'll be lower. Sometimes it'll create a negative fund balance, sometimes your very positive fund balance. So the SPLOS 6 number, you still have $2,454,000 left to spend on that one. The previous year, the old SPLOS 5 was completely spent out. So 6 is, you see very little activity in the revenue. That's just some interest that they're earning on that money. And then you'll see that play out in the next couple of years. The CDBG grant, that's an in and out kind of deal. Money comes in, you spend it. So that normally should be a break even type deal. Public roads, $1,350,000 in revenues, $1,100,000 in expenditures. And then SPLOS 7 is the big one that's going on right now.
Joe, is there any expectation on when we would be closing out SPLOS 6?
SPLOS 6 is the Parks and Rec funds, and that is being prepared now. Chad will go over the bid process on that when he gets here.
Okay.
But that is in the process. Man, so that, correct, Harrison, that's all the things that's left.
Yeah, I asked him if they were building a missile silo. He said they were building a soccer field.
Yeah.
It's just been a long time coming.
How long was that? Six.
Well, the money's been collected.
I know. Yeah.
So we began to collect that, and were looking for property and did not find the size of the property until much later. So
we just got spending 2.4 minutes.
Yeah. Now it is because all of those SPLOST numbers were lower, we had anticipated, I think initially on that, like 180, we hit maybe 150. And so all the projects had to be reduced. Now, I say all the projects, once you begin to do brick and mortar type construction, you don't have the option of going in there and saying, well, we're going to take out maybe 10%. Yeah. So we had to look at projects that we wouldn't be able to do. So the money here is less than what we had anticipated and what Parks and Rec anticipated. Also, Harrison, was this the SPLOST that included the parking deck for the hospital?
I believe so.
And that was anticipated to be like $1.5 million from the county. And it really turned out to be about $700,000 that we would, so a little less than half of what we were able to provide then, because that was a project city and county. So I don't know what the city did on that, but our reduction was down about half. So is that answer on the?
I think so. Yeah.
Yeah, when you get your CAFRA, there'll be a schedule of projects. It'll be on page 147, and it'll be a list of projects that are still under SPLOST 6, and then the next page will be the projects under SPLOST 7. And it'll show percentage complete and all that.
What is SPLOST 7 again?
December 20.
It goes through 2019 and will end January 2020, right?
Right.
Yeah.
Okay, so it'll end January 2020, not December 2020.
No, it ends December 2020.
December 2020.
Yeah, so we're really 2 years and 10 months left.
Okay.
That's right.
So it doesn't end December of 19.
Yeah.
No, it ends December 2020.
Yeah. And your vote would be in 2020 unless you back it all the way up.
Which we did have the option of bringing it up early, the next block, then when it's actually scheduled.
Which is what happened to previous.
Yeah.
So we will have a vote on probably 2019.
That's one of the vision questions.
Any questions on the capital projects? Any other questions? Okay. Flip over to the next page, page 5. And this has the enterprise funds and the internal service funds. So under the enterprise funds, the total revenues for the year were $7,979,000 compared to $6,851,000 previous year. Expenditures were $4,967,000 compared to previous year $4,855,000. And you drop on down to operating transfers in and out, you'll see that had transfers out of $558,000 this year, transfers in of $2,990,000 last year. So that transfers in was SPLOST projects from somewhere else. So so we didn't have as much activity this year under the SPLOST. The water sewer total revenues were $7,291,000. Expenses were $4,595,000, and our change in net position for the water sewer was 2,309,000 this year. Anything, any other questions on the primary funds?
What are revenues are up about? 7,291 this year and 6,199 last year.
Internal service funds, those are the funds that the county uses internally. There's a new fund this year, the technology fund. It had 469,000 in it in revenue, 401 in expenses. The health department had a loss of 498,000 on revenues of 5,751,000. The equipment fund had a net income of 574,000 on revenues of 2,963,000. Our workers' comp broke even based on the revenue of 908. Any questions on the internal service?
Quick question. I was just wondering, how do our workman come break even? I guess what would you suggest that you really
I make it break even.
Yeah.
We, anytime with an internal service fund, it looks like it's going to dip way down or even go into a deficit. We adjust and spread it back over all the funds. And in this particular case, the actuarial liability went up and it was going to go into a deficit. And I decided that,
no,
we can't let
them
do that.
Yeah, I was just wondering, you know.
Yeah, the expenses are just charges to other funds.
Yeah.
So you can adjust it to
yeah, that. And I just adjusted it break even. That was coincidental.
And usually, that is the prudent thing to do.
That's better than having the deficit.
Yeah, because we have gone into some that have a negative deficit, and they don't ever recognize it in their general funds or their water sewer or whatever. They have large deficits sitting there. I think the GASB may address that at some point.
Kind of disguising the loss, keep that in the internal service fund and not transferring it over to the other funds.
So, Enron accounting.
Any other questions? Certainly appreciate the opportunity.
Thank you. Thank you, sir.
We should have that final out in the next week or so, and don't expect any changes, but if there are any, obviously we'll come back.
Okay.
All right.
Thank you. You're going to give us a discount next year.
Oh, yes, sir. He gave us one this year.
25% after he doubles his head. It's always good to get a positive audit report, so we appreciate it.
Thank you very much. I will say this, y'all. We have been very, very fortunate in our relationship with Mark and Henderson Viking. They have been very easy to work with. They are very cooperative with staff. There's a clear understanding when they come in, the information they need. They've got their own nest made. They share with Harrison over on finance, and Scott is the team leader that comes in and begins that process. And the cooperation between Henderson Godby and Harrison, as well as the staff, been very, very pleasant, very professional, very cordial, and very efficient. And do you agree or take that? We might turn a little bit. Silent head nod is
agreement, but I do appreciate y'all's professionalism, and I appreciate y'all's cooperation. Mark, for some of your background, used to provide auditing services in Ware County for a time period when I was up there. He casually mentioned to me one day while I was the manager over there, have you thought about going to Lowndes County? They have an opening over there. You need to consider this. And I asked him, have you lost your mind? What have I done to you? But if y'all want to blame somebody, he was one of the ones.
Or if we choose to give credit. Thank you, Mark.
Thank you very much. Certainly appreciate it.
For both. Recommend you go and head for the report.
Right. Thank you, y'all.
Can you find your way back out?
I think we can find our way back out. Thank you.
The road should be good and smooth all the way.
Appreciate it. Marcus, I got you.